In this video, let's use our auto digitize option. I want to find a JPEG. It works best if you have a high res image. Let's try this Google logo. You can edit the size if you would like. Then when it brings you to the color page, it will usually exclude the white, as most of the time the white is the background. Now, if I want this inner ring to be digitized, I want to click on the white. The background here does have this checkerboard pattern. I do not need those light gray squares, so I can unclick that. Let's finish it out. All right, so we have our image here. It looks like it did pick up these gray circles. So we just want to, let's say, we can deselect those here. It also deselected the white in the middle. Now we can easily create a white circle here. Let's first look at our inclinations, and we can take a 3D look as well to see how this will look stitched out. The inclination is the direction of each stitch. So here in the blue, that looks pretty good. Let's check on the green. It's left to right. I kind of want it to match the blue. Let's try that. The yellow is kind of going the other way. I think that will be fine. This is going up and down. Let's kind of adjust this to be side to side. And so everything looks pretty good. If I want that center circle, I can, using the complex fill, create a fill. If you have Inspire, you will need to do this manually. So we can create a circle using our stitch tool, or if you have Plus or Luxe, we can create an ellipse using the artwork tool. And by holding down Control, it will make a perfect circle. I can see if this fits well here. Let's adjust it. I do want it to overlap just a little bit. And now I can use my Convert To option and create a complex fill. Let's make it a white. So I'll right click on my color. And now I want it to go backwards so that it's underneath the inner circle. We can use our keys up here, move to back, and now it's underneath the blue. I don't really need the white to be stitching out all the way underneath the blue. I don't need those stitches. We can trim. So if you have Plus or Luxe, you can do this. Let's find our blue circle here. We will hit Control to select both. And, oops. All right, they're both selected. Now I can click on right click. I will select the blue, and I will select the gray, and right click. We're using our shaping tool, and I want to trim. So if I took out the blue, you can see that the white is just an open ring now. I do want to make sure these are all overlapping just enough, so let's just make this white ring a little bit larger. That way it can correctly overlap underneath the red, the green, the yellow, and then the blue. I can make this also a little bit larger. And I'm holding down my control key to make sure that it stays a perfect circle. And there you have it. We used our auto digitize feature and we made a couple edits, and we can now see how it'll stitch out. We have the white, the red, the yellow, green, and then lastly the inner circle of blue. Awesome. And to print our run sheet, we can do file, print preview, and then here we have it, it's very large. Each segment of the design will show you how it stitches out, in what order, on the run sheet. It is pretty large. If I wanted to resize it, I can select the entire design and just drag one of the corners to make it smaller. All right, that's it.